Many of us have been running from the fire and the thunderings. It is not sent to kill you. It's not sent to destroy you. It is sent to bring you to that point where indeed you will die to every inclinations of the world system and alive to the ultimate one. Stop running away from the fire. Enter into that fire. Let him kiss you. God is seeing us as He's seen as a vehement flame. It's called, it's a dimension of the flames of God that needs to be kindled upon the heart of man that will consume you from inside. The Israelites, they call him Sheli Batia. God, the vehement flame. When that flame kindled upon your heart, you will know that there is something that is worth pursuing other than mundanity. Many of us, the reason why we are fasting and killing ourselves is so that we will have prophetic. And the idea behind the prophetic is not because we have body to help people, so that we can bamboozle people and then we will collect their money and then we will live large and come as senior prophet. The end of the seeking is not to know God. The end of the seeking is for self-preservation. That same thing that Jesus is laboring to kill is what we are desiring so much to preserve. We need an encounter with the dimension of Chelhibatia, God, the vehement flame. Because that is the solution to this infirmity that we have found ourselves in. That he will kiss us with the kisses of his lips. Because his love is better than wine. As choice wine is desirous to the drunk. That is how the kisses of the immortal is desirous to him that have been kindled on his inside. So a day without talking to him is like, it's like you are dead. It's like something is wrong with you. But many of us go months and we don't remember our prayer altar because the last time we were kissed, it's been long. Meanwhile, the altar of prayer is a place where you come in to interact. A place of intercourse. A place where you mingle with him and become one with him. So that his flame will consume you from inside out. So that when you appear on the scene, even though things are flashing, things are calling your name, you can't hear. Because you are locked up in the realm that is not connected to anything in this natural world. You are locked up. You are busy. Sometime, my friend will walk into my room. Then we stay together. He say, Kai, you need to hear what the Holy Ghost has been telling me. And then I will feel like a sinner. I say, wait, Lord, I've been here since morning. Why did you leave me and go and be talking to him since morning? And all me I'm doing is fighting battles. When I complain, he will laugh. He say, forget, I'm a prophet. Moses said, he wish that all of us are prophet.
Lost. Seeking for things that cannot be found in time. You are looking for what is found in time because you have made yourself a creature of time. Wise men look for things that time cannot host. The journey beyond the veil of time to tap into realities that are locked up away from the realm of time so that when they appear in time, the rain has caused. If you take census, whatever it is that is the object of obsession to you now. Eh? No matter how, think of it, if it is Bugatti Veyron, if it's Rolls Royce Phantom, whatever it is, subject it to the verdict of time, you will discover that a judgment is on it. It's vanity. It's vanity. The day God delivered me from the desires of the world was a day I was traveling for a meeting in the east. And the vehicle passed behind, before one mansion. If you see the mansion, pass. Anything money could achieve was achieved there. Limousine was parked there. The limousine was deflated, rusted. Nobody attending to it. And then the Holy Spirit began to teach me wisdom. This is the end of vanity. It's a manifestation of vanity. Whatever the object of your pursuit is, if it is not after immortal realities, it is a waste. So when you are 70, you are 8, you look back, you discover that all you use your lifetime to achieve is house and cars. It's a fake life. Wise men, press it to God. Wise men die on the altar because they know that to have a place among the immortals, you must be willing to journey. And it's not a journey of one day. Bible spoke concerning Enoch. He said he walked with God and he was not, for God took him. He did not appear and was taken one day. He went today, came out, went 2 days, stayed there, came out, went 1 month, stayed there, went 6 months there, until God said, no, you have crossed the threshold of mortals. You can't stay among mortals anymore. Come up. And he was sucked into eternity. I read the story of a man that burned my heart. He's called the Maharishi of Mount Kailash. This man was an intercessor. He was burdened with the burden of God so much that he prayed all the time. Until he got to a point that he said, no, neighbors are disturbing him. He left civilization and went to stay in a mountain called Tibet, the mountain of Tibet in India. There, Jesus appeared to him, took his mortal heart and gave him an immortal heart. He said, you will not see death. The man have lived for more than 400 years. No death. He's there. What's he doing? Traveling for the soul of humanity. Some of you are feeling you are a prayer man. You don't know who came to strengthen you when that demon came to knock you off. You don't know who appeared in your room that night when you were almost taken away with slumber. You don't know the angel of fire that appeared in your room and gave you a knock and said, get up, and energy entered into you. This is why it is a childish thing to be proud in this kingdom. The Maharishi of Mount Kailash, the man that told the story, is a man called Sadhu Sundasi. He was the one that encountered that man when he was traveling for mission work to an unknown destination. And he fell into a cave. Saw a being full of beards. That one doesn't need permission to break into the heaven. He entered into heaven like he is a member of the elders there. He enters a tree. Take the counsel of the immortal and watch it over the sons of men. So when Anthony Joshua is tired, I want to begin to complain, Father, this thing is too. Then the Maharishi of Mount Kailash.
They reappear like a covering cherub. And then suddenly, strength from nowhere. Listen, all of us at one point or the other have been knocked down. But by the mystery of how we stood up again and keep holding the flag, we don't know. But it is a function of connections in the spirit. Don't think you are alone. They that are with you, they are more than they that you can see. Don't allow the things you are going through to become a distraction. That is the stepping stone into glory.